Hey guys, so there's like a belief out there because railgun has less DPS compared to artillery that makes railgun a worse weapon compared to artillery. Well, I've explained this in another video before, but that wasn't, you know, a video dedicated for this. So I'm just gonna really quickly explain why every serious warship on space engineers needs railguns. The first reason is that, well, it's very easy to dodge enemy artillery fire. Like you guys can see here, we're below 800 meters, and I can easily dodge those enemy artillery fire if your ship has enough acceleration. This is very easy to do. That's why I always mention in my critical ship review that, well, your ship, if it's a warship, needs a good amount of acceleration. And the second reason is first strike capability, because in survival, if you're fighting someone, whether you're, you know, actually fighting or you're ambushing someone, if you don't disable their jump drive, it's possible for your enemy to jump away, which is, you know, the sensible thing to do. So the point of, you know, having railguns is that you would maximize your chance of actually disabling the enemy ship or at least the jump drive on your first strike of the enemy ship, or, you know, on the enemy ship. So the fact that the artillery cannon has more DPS compared to the railgun is irrelevant, because, well, the point of a railgun is that it has a higher chance of hitting fast moving enemies, and it has more damage per hit, which increases the chance of you actually disabling your enemy ship when you actually hit the enemy. Now, that doesn't mean artillery cannons on a ship or, well, Gatling turret and artillery turret are pointless. They certainly have their own uses as well. But if you're serious about actually disabling, you know, another player's ships, then you need railguns, or at least it's a good idea to have railguns. So, that's the two real reasons why warships need railguns on space engineers.